Welcome. This is going to be the very last lecture in this course. Okay. Now we will review and practice what we have learned in week 14. PCA and ANN. In this week we have learned handwriting number detection using artificial neural network on MNIST dataset. Okay. We learned how the post office have studied and made and use it now in the post office to recognize the zip code of our handwritten numbers and sorting them to be delivered, without any delay. And this is the set of the handwritten numbers in NIST data set, which can be found here. And this is the GitHub source for the related informations. And this is a code that we have made to show you in this lecture. This is a Sage code. So here we call the needed libraries, and then read the CSV files from the data set in this web address, and then visualize the code, visualize the number that we did choose. If we learn the code, then this will recognize it was a number looks like this. If we change this value to 1, then what? Let's see which number will be appeared. The training data 1 here. And if we call the different number, then it will give us which number? Number 2, like this. The other number will be appeared if we choose the different training data. Okay? Then we will recognize this number as a matrix, 28 by 28, a matrix like this, which can be considered as 781 vector as an input. Then 784 by 1 vector is used to as an input data, and after the neural network, then we will have output. That will say that this number looks like not 1 or 2, but 7, like this. Okay? If there is an in this neural network, they will check if there is an error between this given number and what should be recognized, then the gradient descent method and backpropagation algorithm will be used to update the weight until it decides the one number among 0 to 9. So in this case, 7 was the most reasonable answer. Okay, and all the source will be and data can be found on here, which was used in our textbook. Okay, this is a real code for those processes. Okay, you see, here is the code we will call. This is a code to learn MNIST data with 3 layers of neural network, and we will import the library, and then this code will work for us to figure out what is the given handwritten numbers. And here we used the input code 784 and hidden node 100 and output node as 10 from 0 to 9. And learning rate was set as 0.3 and load CSV file and from this web address, and we gave epoch 5. If we increase this number, then it will give us more accuracy of it. etc. And then you will print out what? We have. Okay. If you learning this, then it will give us about 60% at this time. It was when I did learn it before, it was about 70%. But if we increase this training data from 100 to 60,000 and the test data from 100 to 10,000, then at 10 test data to 10,000 test data, then we will see this number will be about 95% accuracy. So as the data set is getting bigger and bigger, and our computing power is getting improved. So, yeah, the only thing that we can we have to do is to improve the number of epoch, number of data, and use the better computer. Then we will have accuracy that exceeds the human's ability to recognize the handwritten letter, and number, or sound, or images, like that. Mm-hmm. And these are the images that we can find that we did use the same code for the bigger data. Okay, here we are in the last stage. Okay. When we deal with the natural language process, ANN will analyze the real meaning of what we said and will try to give us the best possible answers to help us to make a better decision in a short time. For example, when I say I want a pizza to my smartphone, then AI system will try to understand what I said, the meaning of what I said. So he will decide that the meaning as I want to eat pizza because there is no other word such as recipe or the cooking. So they next AI use GPS information to find the restaurants nearby me, and AI order the rest will give a list in order the restaurants by distance and cost effectiveness. After finding a restaurant and figure out the restaurant's name and address, an AI is ready to make recommendations to me. And then a message will be generated, and then it will be turning into a statement in a natural language. So AI will tell me the sentence which is like this. There is a Gino's Pizza House in the right of 1 kilometer ahead. Okay. For a driverless car case, if we ask AI in driverless car, driverless car, auto car, to take me to the COEX Convention Center, then AI will recognize the meaning and find the best route through the navigation and drive me safely to COEX. Okay, while AI driving my car, I can do whatever I want to do, get prepared for the meeting at there. Okay, this is the kind of life that all of us will enjoy sooner or later. Okay, I gave some open problems in the lectures for 13th and 14th week to practice and find your output and then discuss with others on your output and the questions that has been raised. And this is a web address that I made that the Python code will be practiced directly. I think that's the end of the lecture of 14th week, which is the last lecture before the final exam. Thank you for your hard work for whole 14 weeks of lectures on introductory mathematics for AI. Thank you.